Hello everyone and welcome back to Bitwig Studio and Music Production. This is lesson 5.54, and in this lesson we're going to talk about the filter envelope. The filter envelope and the amplitude envelope are pretty much one and the same with a couple of key differences, because the amplitude envelope is always going to be hardwired to the output, right? This is setting our maximum value. With the filter envelope, we don't really have a maximum value set. We wouldn't always want this to modulate and assume that we want to go up to the maximum here. So we have to have an amount control, and we also need to have a direction control. Do we want this going up, or do we want it going down? So we have that control here, and in Bitwig, we also have a curve, okay? So how that's actually going to move, is it going to be real sharp, or is it going to be a little bit more pronounced? So let's take a look at this, and it's really not too complicated. If you have any confusion at this point, I'd say go back and watch the video on the amplitude envelope, because it's really one and the same. So I'm going to play our sound back. And now if I want this filter to move, I'm going to do a move that isn't going to make a whole lot of sense, but we'll find out in a second what that is. All right, so that doesn't seem to be having any effect, and it's not going to be having any effect because we're moving our depth in a positive direction. Well, we're already at 20k or whatever, so we can't go any higher than that, or even if we do, we're not going to hear a difference. This goes beyond the range of our human hearing and probably beyond the capabilities of this filter. So what I'd have to do is pull this down. And now what we're hearing is this frequency being brought down and then staying down, okay? The sustain is all the way up to 100%. I could increase the attack. And then I could also kind of increase this bias here so we can hear the differences with it all the way up. Really speeds it all up. Or down the other way. Like so. All right, and what is this the equivalent to? I'll show you right now. We're gonna add on a filter. Okay, we'll set these up the same. Set this to 0. And now I can add an automation lane in here. And I'd like to increase the size so we can see what's happening. If I select something, it gives me that value. So right now we're starting at the very top and we're fading down somewhere to about here. It won't go all the way to 0, but it's going to be close. So we can take a listen to this. So that's really all we're doing. And then we can change this by holding Option. So we have our one mode or our other mode. This is really exactly what the synthesizer is doing. And we're setting the direction here. So if I wanted to, I could actually inverse this, and I'll do it in the polysynth. And I think you guys get the idea in here, but I could take the frequency, pull it all the way down, and then just shift this all the way up. And now take a listen. So we can hear that getting brighter over time, and we can change these biases. So one thing you're going to notice, like right off the bat, is even if we go up by plus 64, we're not getting everything. It won't go all the way up. So you have to be kind of aware of that if you're trying to go for something really extreme. We need to kind of have some sound coming through at the start. And And then what we can do is we can change the sustain so that after the attack portion has occurred, it's going to jump back to somewhere relative to its default. So if I go all the way down to zero, it's going to fade up and then immediately jump back to this point, this 319 hertz, which would be the same thing as this going from here and then immediately shooting back up. So let's take a listen. So that's really fast. But we could set different locations for this as well. So we could have it maybe in this region as compared to right down there. Etc. And then the decay, if we want to add in any decay here, that's just going to impact how long it takes to go back to whatever our sustain level is. So let's say we want our sustain level to be in this region. This line here is indicating that decay time. So I'll increase the decay time. And now it's going to be a little bit more gradual and smooth. As opposed to... And then release is just going to indicate how if we want when we release the key and if there's actually some release on our amplitude envelope, that's going to then allow us to kind of start to fall back again to our default position here. So let's increase the release time. We'll increase the release time on this really high. And take a listen. Okay, so now as I let go, you can hear it start to lose some brightness. If I increase the sustain here, we'll really be able to hear it. And now listen to this sound as it starts to lose its brightness. Without that release on, it just immediately jumps right back, okay? So not incredibly natural. You're going to want some release so that we can start to fade back to this slowly, unless you're going for that kind of an effect. Stays bright, now starts to dull. If we put this all the way up to 100, it's going to probably stay bright all the way through this release stage. And ever so subtly changing, but we can change these curves as well, which gives even more variety. And if you hype the heck out of the curve going up in this direction, okay, it's actually going to allow the frequency to go a bit higher than if we're just stating it right here with this more linear line. So we'll compare the two. And now with some bias. Or the other way. We obviously are barely moving at all. There we go. There's that nice sharp. So if you can learn how to really control your filter, a lot of times you don't even have to do that much inside of the amplitude envelope, because if we're like changing the relative dullness or brightness of our sound, that means that we're either adding or removing harmonics. And by adding or removing harmonics, we're also adding or removing relative gain. Okay, so the filter envelope, just as important as the amplitude envelope, and a lot of times it can be more important, because if I want to make like a plucky type sound, right now I can just pull this down and then a tiny bit of an initial attack. And now other synthesizers are going to do this differently as well. So do be aware of that. I've I've already made another one here just of the polysynth so you can hear what I came up with. All right, and that's not even using any LFO. All it's using is our filter envelope and our amplitude envelope, and not even any kind of extreme settings in the amplitude envelope at all. Hope that's been helpful for you guys. Get in there, mess around with it, see what sort of sounds you can come up with, and let me know what you think. So until the next lesson, take care.